Hello, I'm Steve with Touch of the Master's Hand, Holy Spirit Ministries. I wanted to talk today about many are called, but few are chosen. I'm going to kind of dive right into it. And then in a little bit, I'll tell you about my eye, which looks kind of jacked up, but and it is. But anyhow, I want to dive into the message, and then I'll kind of explain to you a few other things. I'll kind of fill you in. Matthew 20 is an awesome scripture. And I'm going to have to use a magnifying glass because my eye is really jacked up. So I'm going to use my reading glasses and a magnifying glass, so bear with me. So the last will be first, and the first last. For many are called, but few are chosen. I'm going to, not read all of it. It's Matthew 20. It's talking about the kingdom of God, kingdom of heaven, and it's like a piece of land. It's like a land, and the king wanted laborers to go out into the field, promised them all the same pay. So I'm going to kind of paraphrase it. Don't take my word for it. Read it for yourself. Because it's not really my interpretation. It's just the leading of the Lord, Jesus. So, promised them all the same. The end of the day, people that toiled the most, longest, early in the morning, thought they would, came time to get paid, and he sent the servants out, paid the last first. So when the first came, they thought they would get more. And they didn't, and they kind of copped an attitude. They expected more. So it isn't mine to do it mine, what I want. Didn't you agree for the same wage? I mean, we're all promised the same. So, God's calling his people. He's calling the church. He's calling the marriage supper of the Lamb. Are we really listening? A lot of people aren't. A lot of the church world isn't. The people he's calling are just kind of ignoring it. They got stuff to do and things going on, People can get involved in ministries, and this is not, there's two sides to this coin, but, may not have a Billy Graham ministry or movement in your life. It doesn't mean anything in the kingdom of God. Really, honestly, it doesn't. We're all just vessels. We all have a certain place and a role and gifting and calling and talents. Maybe to reach the person in the cubicle next to you. Maybe to reach your neighbor who's a town grouch. And the Lord may tell you to go buy him a set of tires for his car. I don't know. Could be a healing ministry. Gifts of interpretation of tongues. One of my gifts is gifts of visions. And I'll tell you about a book that the Lord inspired me to write. It's just a tool, and I spent a year putting scriptures to go with it because it's another one of my messages. Who's your source? That's what you're going to find in all, intertwined in all my messages. Who's your source? God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit, and the Bible. You can't go wrong there. Directing you there. It's not me. It's not about me. Nothing to do. I'm just a vessel. It took me 35 years to get here. My resume, in some ways, is good. In some ways, it sucks. And there's a lot of destruction and mess in my Christian resume, and a lot of victories. Right now, I'm in victory mode, and I'm going to stay there no matter what. This thing with my eye is not even really a setback. It just emboldened me. So, God's calling his people out from amongst, There's a lot of religiosity in this world. I'm picking on any one denomination or even a charismatic mood. They all have things going on, but Jesus wants to be the main focus because that's the hour we live in. That's the time we live in. That's God's perfect plan for mankind, for the salvation of mankind. He's calling. And it's not, I'm better than, because that's what the religious piece of the world says, and most of America, there's a lot of religious out there, religious stuff. I grew up in it. It's like a bag of apples. You got time to separate and find out, take the good and the bad, take the good out and throw away the bad. There's things that have been put in us. Look at my message on what's on your mind. Enemy wants to flood your mind with crap. And it can't even be through the church world or through things that seem like they're really God, but just because you have a lot going on and big buildings or whatever, or just seem like, I've reached a million souls. Okay, great, awesome. money doesn't signify a move of God. I've seen a move with nothing, but money is a tool. We all need it. There's nothing wrong with having a nice car and a nice house. Things of God, that, you know, a church should support the pastors and the men and women of God and evangelists. And, you know, absolutely, positively. Tithes are a big part of it. Just going to the storehouse. I get it. I understand that. You know, people can get all twisted up with things. But God's calling his people because it's about reaching the souls. That's what this book is that the Lord inspired me to write. It's called Visions and Writings of Promise, Hope, and a Future for America. We're in a grace dispensation because that's the way God created it. And it's all about reaching souls. But there's other sides to that, too. We have to work on the souls that are already reached, the people that already, you know, have given their life to Jesus or the Holy Spirit. You know, there's strength in it, you know. It's just, it's an awesome time of living in. There's a lot of, the whole world's being called, but only a few are chosen. Let's go to Gideon, and then I'm going to kind of end with that, and tell you about my eye, and then kind of end with that. So, and the Lord said to Gideon, the people who are with you are too many for me to give you, the Midianites into their hands, lest Israel claim glory for itself against me, saying, my own hand has saved me. That's the peace. When you're called, you are chosen, you all have the same promise, whether you do what seems like miraculous, awesome, really grand things or not. We're all the same authority, power, significance in the kingdom of God. Some of the bigger name preachers may disagree with that, but you know, that's okay. We're all at different stages of maturity in Christ. It's part of the journey. They just may be more mature and more deeper in Christ because they've been longer walking for God. Wished I had for 35 years. Hadn't. But the experiences I have, my wife and I have a broken-hearted ministry, and we preach at a homeless shelter in Dallas. I can reach those people because, A, I have a broken heart and a drug-addicted past up till 20 years old. And I was 33 before I got delivered of something that was in my heart that I didn't even realize was there from a child. A hook that the enemy had, and I blamed myself and hung on to that even though I was going to church. So I got a brokenhearted experience, and I'll later on in a different message I'll minister on that. We're called. Are we really listening? God wants to choose his people, call us out from amongst the world, separate ourselves. You know, it is about living holy and right, pure and clean. You're going to want to once you accept Jesus into your heart. And the Holy Spirit leads, guides, and directs you to all truths. And God's living within you. And you study the Word. Always go to the Word, you know. There's just so many awesome directions this message could take. But God's calling, and few are chosen. There's a reason and a purpose behind everything that God's doing in your life. Nothing you do is insignificant for God. None of us are insignificant. We all have a... I can't reach the people that you reach. You know, this is what happened to my eye. In San Diego, on our 30th wedding anniversary, visiting our kids, dozen awesome things happened in the spirit, Joanne. Prayer, leading us to people. I won't make this message longer by going into the story. It was just awesome. God moved in mighty, mighty, mighty ways. And the children and the people that I ministered to, because I asked God in prayer. What happened was I went up to the beach and told the Lord, I said, I wanted to sit on this bench, one of these benches, and minister to somebody. Send somebody that I can minister to. 30 minutes went by, some crazy guy came by talking to this lady's dog, and talked to anybody else, people around him, talked all kinds of crazy. I kept telling him about Jesus. He finally wandered, you know, and I was like, God, it didn't really help him. I didn't deliver him. Didn't even really reach him for Jesus. He was just crazy acting. Stuff. 30 minutes went by. God, am I supposed to just sit here? Is it all about, you know, what are you teaching me? What are you showing me? I don't have to be an ordinary day, da da da. Got a chance to minister to three different people that were in a group that were really in the midst of a strong trial and still are, and God's calling them, and they're some of God's chosen people. And kept in contact with them. This was a week ago. Well, I get back to Dallas, went back 30 minutes, unloading my toiletries, and what I thought were eye drops were actually a bottle of the stuff that we put in. It looked like the eye drop bottle was about the stuff we put in our water for our alkaline to neutralize the acid in there. Burned my crap out of my eye. Bad. Like, really bad. So, prognosis from the doctor, blah, 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 kind of just not good. Kind of like one-eyed Pete. I got this weird-looking contact, really thick thing in my eyeball. It's just a trick of the enemy. And some of it's stupidity, some of it's ignorance. I was tired, been up since 2 in the morning, had an 8, and just wasn't paying attention to what I was doing. That's, you know, I didn't hear that instruction from the Lord, but that's true, you know, so I just got to kind of go with the flow. Been an expensive lesson, over $1,000 already. But it's just the enemy trying to get a foothold and trying to stop what God's doing in the people's lives that we got a chance to pray for, and the things that the Lord's showing me, and the direction he's going. I'm not stopping. That's not hindering me. I'll grab my glasses and my magnifying glass and study the Word, and preach and teach the truth and proclaim the liberty of the gospel of Jesus to those that are lost. I ministered Sunday night at the homeless shelter. I'm not going to stop because of an issue. The next day, the Lord told me, he said that what the enemy meant for destruction, he was going to use for us. Jesus was going to take that for instruction and give you power to tread upon serpents. So you know what? I'm going to stand on that. It's not about miracles. I need one. But God told me it's going to happen. So this is going to be a testimony one day of God's healing grace. Awesome. Until then, I'm going to just kind of deal with it and take God's instruction and learn. And just, there's things coming out of it. So, many are called, but only a few are chosen. Separate yourself. God has a purpose and a reason for where you're at. You know? And don't take my word for it. Go to your source. Look at some of my other videos. Go to your source. Jesus, God, Holy Spirit, the Bible. Real briefly, because I want to keep this to 15 minutes. In the midst of a trial with one of my sons, my wife's in the backdrop. You need to get in the car, burn rubber, go over there and just shake the crap out of him and let him know the seriousness of the situation and how it's affecting his family and us and everybody else around him. And it was all blown up. And it was serious. Spare you the details. Extremely serious. A mess. My wife had to do something or went somewhere. I started praying, walking through the house, praying, mad at the enemy. Kind of mad at myself, maybe even a little bit. Mad at God. Trying not to be. Probably not praying in the right direction. Kind of went down that mode, that vein. Finally, threw up my hands and said, Jesus, what would you do? Took me to his word. Told me months ago, I always go to his word when I was having issues or problems. And it was in the midst of another trial. But he said, I always go to my word. So that's what he did. He said, James 5:17, and it talks about the wisdom from above, peaceful, gentle, meek, you know, opposite of what I wanted to do as a dad, shake the crap out of my son and tell him, you know, give him peace of my mind, set him straight, slap him upside his head, opposite of that. Because if you read on farther down, it says we were once sinners and needed grace, and you just read the whole chapter. So, I did that, stepped back, showed my son grace and mercy, and prayed for him. and left it in God's hands. Talk to him, but in a different realm. Things completely changed for the good, and the outcome was awesome and great. And it's been great for the past couple of years. So, God's calling, and he's calling a chosen people to separate themselves because you have a purpose. It's a purpose-driven life. Like I said, it may not be a Billy Graham ministry. That's okay. I can't reach the people you can reach, and you can't reach the people that God has intended for me to reach. We all have a purpose. Even my prodigal son experience had a purpose. Because now I can minister to the homeless people because I know what it's like to be angry at God. I spent years in that mode. And there's a lot of anger at God. A lot of religiosity you have to dump out. False teachings. Man before God. A lot of that. But it's God before man. Jesus before man. And the Holy Spirit before man. As ministers, we can get stuck on that and get caught up in that, and as God moves in such a mighty way, it's a battle. It really is, at least for me. So, it's not about me. It's about you and your walk with God and your purpose-driven life that God ordained and wants you to move in the realm of him. He's calling. He's choosing you. Are you going to listen? Are you going to follow him? To do what he tells you to do. Sometimes it doesn't even make sense. That's why I said lean not on your understanding, you know, and all your ways acknowledge him and love him and show you with your whole heart. So, many are called, but a few are chosen. So it's time to separate ourselves, walk into the realm of what God wants to do in your life, what Jesus wants to do, what the Holy Spirit wants to do. Just an awesome, awesome experience, awesome time to be a Christian. Look at some of my other videos, share them with others. You know, if you want a copy of this book, it's free, called Visions and Writings of Promise, Hope, and the Future. It took me several years to, 6, 8, 10 months to write it, and almost as long to study the Bible and to put scripture with it. And God told me to leave out the interpretation. It's just a tool. That's all it is. Not me, not the book. It's just my message and my direction is get closer to Jesus. Get you walk right with God, the Holy Spirit, Jesus, all three living in you. You want that message? I got it. It's called God's Image in You. I'll send you that. Email me at steveyoungstrom@yahoo.com if you got personal, regular comments you want to make. Comment on my YouTube channel. Email me your address and I'll mail you the book. No strings attached. No bunch of, not ask for an offering, not going to send you a bunch of junk, nothing. The book. That's it. Just want to get that out there. Because I know it's an awesome tool that the Lord inspired me to write. This is one of the gifts that the Lord's given me. Many of y'all have all kinds of gifts, talents, you know. Let me hear from you. Love you. Appreciate you. God's awesome. And there's more to come. My wife's going to start next week. I really felt led to, you know, I always felt led that she needed to be involved, but she's got an awesome healing testimony in her life. An awesome miracle that God did. She was 56 years old before, 54, I'm sorry. And she'd been battling it since 15. God is a good God. And he's calling you because you're chosen. Or you wouldn't be listening to this. Come out from amongst the world, whether it's the world that's all around us. Go turn on the news and it's a bunch of crap. I barely watch it anymore. Same with on the internet. There's all this stuff that pops up on my screen before I go to YouTube. And maybe even the religious world, because that, you know, I mean, that's who put Jesus to death. The religious hierarchy stirred up the people, and they put him to death. So people can claim to be a church, or a move of God, and be far from the truth. Because if Jesus, God, Jesus, the Holy Spirit aren't first, man becomes first. I'm not anti-church. It's real important that we gather together, that we, you know, it's a corporate body, that we have a church, that we have a spiritual leader, that we have a pastor. It's real important. They're going to get direction and correction that we may not get, things that we need. There's a purpose and an order in that. We need to flow in that. What I'm saying is it needs to be right. Not all this man-made junk, and there's a lot of it out there. I grew up in some of it. God had to separate me from it, pull me out, teach me the truth. I'm not the only one. I'm not cornering the market. I'm not saying I'm it. I'm not, you know, trying to claim to be the Messiah or anything kind of weird or off the wall. There's other good ministries out there, and preachers and teachers and evangelists. And maybe even some people in, well, not even maybe, but people in the church. There's a lot of good things out there going on. It's Jesus-focused, God-focused, the Holy Spirit-focused, and the Bible-focused. You can't go wrong there. Consider your source, go to your source, ask Jesus, ask God, ask the Holy Spirit. All three are one. All three can live in you, want to live in you, abide in you. The Word can be a living part of you. It's just awesome, really. So, calling's there. If you're chosen, move in that realm and watch God do things in your life. You know, it's just, there's so many awesome things I want to share, and I'm just bubbling over and want to just flow out. And so I think I'm going to start putting more messages on here more often, maybe even often. So tune in. Love you. Please comment on it. Likes, dislikes. Doesn't matter. Want to hear from you. 90% of what I say is correct, maybe 10% isn't, in error, not on purpose, not intentional, not because I want to. I'm a person too. I need God to move in some areas of my life too. I need things to transpire too in me, so might be more, might be less, than just throwing that number out there. Grow up. So, if I'm in error, tell me, call me to the carpet, that's fine, that's great, awesome. If not, use the direction I'm giving you, which is your personal relationship with Jesus, the utmost importance, because that's the hour we're living in. Look at some of my other messages, listen to them, glean from them, put it all together into your walk. Just get closer to Jesus. That's what it's all about in the Bible, God, and let the Holy Spirit lead, guide, and direct you to all truths. You can't go wrong. Don't fill your mind with this clutter and stuff, even on the internet or other ministries or other things of the world or distractions, because the enemy can be twist up what seems like something good even into a lie, because his main focus is to destroy your soul. But God's main focus is to set you free. Didn't give us a spirit of fear, but a power and love and a sound mind. There's just tons and tons and tons of awesomeness in the scripture of what God wants to direct his people. And he wants a separate people. And you have to want to live that clean, holy life. That's important. It's a heart issue. Clean up your life. Absolutely. It's not a work thing either. You're going to want to. You're going to love God that much. You're going to love Jesus that much. It's just going to be part of who you are. The direction that you go. So anyhow, many are called, few are chosen. Sorry to be so long. I didn't realize it was going to be this long, but you know, God did. So anyhow, here it is. Love you guys. Appreciate y'all. Tune in. Comments, emails, whatever you want to do. Like I said, email me for a copy of the free book.